Our best friend's been back in the news, guys. A long-time friend of the podcast. Actually, just did Gary. A podcast recently.
Who?
Good old Mr. Musk.
Oh hello, yes.
First of all, Flusky saying Musky. Mr. Musk, just realized, why has this guy not got a fragrance?
Flusky Musky.
Why?
That should be it.
Flusky Musky.
Flusky.
If anyone was born with a name to have a fragrance, Elon Musk.
Musk.
Yo, what are you wearing? Elon. Elon Musk.
No, you call it. Oh, I'm wearing Flusky. Flusky's
Musky. Okay. Yes, I know what you're going
to
say.
Wants to smell like Elon Musk. Things,
what was that?
Elon Musk. Speaking of naming things, Elon Musk had him and his girlfriend Grimes had a baby last week.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I don't know if you're aware.
Yes.
I saw a picture of them two together, right?
Yeah.
They really look like an odd couple.
Well, I think that picture was from the Met Gala, which is the one you were looking at. Yeah. And you were like, is that his wife? So it's his partner, his girlfriend.
So the Met Gala is what?
Where it's like an art, it's like a fundraiser, but for like the arts. Okay. So they dress up. There's a theme that the celebrities have to dress up.
She's dressed up. I've seen other pictures. She dresses up like that all the time.
Yeah, when she's. But then I've seen. Yeah.
He looks like a robot, and she looks like a stripper.
Yeah.
It's weird.
Because that one, she looked like a vampire a bit.
She did.
She looks like a vampire stripper.
So yes, the baby.
The baby now.
It's a vambot.
And by the way, I have heard the name, by the way. Like, I've actually heard audibly the name. Can't remember how it's pronounced, so I'm just going to read it to you. Okay. The name of Elon Musk's baby is X space. The AE symbol that you have in certain languages. Space. A-12.
Can I ruin this or not?
Musk.
It's not what you think it is.
What do you mean? No.
Go on,
ruin it.
Do I ruin it?
It's his computer code.
Ruin it.
His name is Kyle.
No, I heard Rodney, but it's not that. They actually explained. Grimes explained what it is.
It's Kyle, isn't it?
And he explained it. Elon Musk explained it as well.
What did he say?
I'm guessing on paperwork that it's probably something like Kyle. Yeah, I'm guessing that's probably the case.
Well, apparently LA has said you're not allowed to name your baby that because it's illegal. But
hold on. It's illegal to name your baby Kyle.
No, that other.
I was going to say, what did Kyle do to become illegal?
I think you got to show CJ because like it's got a lot of elements and stuff in it.
Oh,
and,
wait. I thought you knew, no? Okay, wait.
I think they converted it.
I can't remember all the pieces, but the last part, the A12, is referenced to his favorite air carrier, which was something they used during the war that was non-violent but incredibly fast.
So what is the name?
Well, I don't know.
Because on Instagram they said the conversion was Kyle.
I've heard it was Rodney on the news.
I think someone else has said that, and the reason why I think they've said that is because if you look at the Greek letters, X is Chi, C-H-I.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
But I know AE, I don't know, like in Icelandic it's pronounced I.
Yeah.
So, Kai. I can see how we've got the first half of Kyle. I think, like that sounds to me like someone's suggested the name's Kyle.
Yeah, all right. Read. Okay. So, So it's not.
I know someone put on there, I know the name, it's Ash Archangel, and he liked it because, the references, one is Archangel, one is Ash.
Something else that, so he was on Joe Rogan again this week, which I need to sit down and watch it. I've only watched parts of it because he always gives out interesting information when he's on there. And they were talking about the Neuralink project, which we've talked about before, which is the chip that gets implanted into your brain, which gives you additional abilities beyond natural scope. But they were talking about like the timeline-ish of when this kind of thing happened and what the implications will be and stuff. And there was one specific implication that kind of rung home for me because of what I'm doing at the moment. And they were talking about basically the expression of thought and expression of ideas. So when you've, like, I'm learning Spanish at the moment, and I say at the moment I've been trying to learn this for a number of years, but it's extremely inconsistent.
Yeah, I first met him was learning Spanish.
Yeah, I'm terrible at the consistency with it, but every time I go back to it, I know more because I can retain more information. I'm recounting it more often and stuff. So like now I'm getting a lot more proficient at it. And like one of the biggest reasons I want to do it is because when I talk to someone, first of all, I can take in information that I couldn't take in before because it's written in a different language. When you translate stuff, it's not quite as accurate. Now, something that I personally have thought about before is your thoughts. Like when you think, you don't think in a language. Like you think in thoughts and then you translate it into language and express it. So, have you ever had a thought where you're like, that didn't come out how it was in my head? Like
every day.
That's not how I meant to explain it. Yeah.
Five, six times a day.
So this whole idea, and that's why when you know multiple languages, like when people say, what do you like translate in your head? Like, no, you don't, because it's the thought that gets translated into language that you express. So regardless of which language you choose to express it in, you're just translating it from the thought to that language and then expressing it. So what Elon Musk was saying was, with this introduction of Neuralink, what will be able to happen is, because they were talking about nonverbal communication, like will you just be able to read each other's mind? Like, will you need to talk? Because if you think, like, if I can use that, for example, if you want to take it the long way around, I could use that to send a text message. But if I could, and if you can read the text message without having to read it, because you can read it through, it's just the same as communicating. Like, you would just.
No.
But then what he's saying is, if you can do that, if you can communicate and understand thought, you can, like, most of an idea, most of a thought gets lost in the translation to the words we use, because we have a limited vocabulary. So you would just understand people's thoughts and ideas and the context around them and everything, like, straight away without having that loss of information between.
Yeah, but you got to have a clear thought. Your thoughts have to be very clear.
Oh, but how? Is.
Well, I from the access standpoint, from the transmission of thoughts, I'm assuming there'll be some sort of access, so you can't just access it. Like, you would choose what thought someone could access.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to send you a thought now.
But I mean, like, how...
That's amazing. I just, like...
That could change everything as far as we understand it.
Wild. Do you know what would happen? Our mouths would get smaller.
So this is something that Joe Rogan talks about. He says...
No!
He says is the depiction of aliens that we've always depicted. Small bodies, big heads, big eyes, small mouths, all this. He says, genitalless. He says, is this just what we actually think we're going to look like in the future? Because we were these big, strong, hairy chimps with small heads that we've now gone to smaller, delicate bodies with bigger heads, bigger eyes, smaller jaws. And he's saying, because evolution is you... As if you don't need to talk, what do you need a mouth for? Eat, I guess. But, like, there'll be transitions of things like that.
I think there's going to be a lot of phasing out of a lot of...
Unnecessary.
People. Yeah, because, like, with that process, you have to have a clear... Like, your thoughts have to be, like, crystal clear. It's like trying to, like... you got to be able to picture that. Like a TV, you know, when your TV, like the LCDs, HD, 4K, has to be that clear for someone to understand the thought that you're going through. Otherwise, if your thought's not clear, it's just going to send mixed messages. It's so weird.
Don't worry, James Cameron and her program it.
Well, at first, until everyone has it, equality will be huge. Inequality will be huge again.
Is everyone equal?
It will get bigger.
I'm just saying, personally, would you want a chip in your head?
Not at first, but if everyone starts getting...
No, not at all.
No, I think it's going to happen with the newborns. I don't think you're going to get a chance.
If I have a kid, they're not putting a chip in his head.
I don't...
Yeah, I don't know.
They put a chip, I put a foot up their ass.
Like, my mind, yes. If it was like an opt-in thing for us, yes, I would get it. Because, like, there's...
What happens if you get hacked?
There's not agreeing with the world you live in, and then there's resisting the world you live in. And, like, I wouldn't necessarily agree with the fact that everyone has these chips, but I would be extremely disadvantaged in life if I didn't have one. So why would I put myself through
that? Why would you be disadvantaged?
And it depends how much they cost. But imagine that, what you said, we're getting hacked. Imagine, like, someone can plant a thought into your head.
Yeah, someone can plant a thought or steal your
thoughts. And make you do something.
How do you know, like, if someone kills someone, he goes, oh, the chip just popped in my
head. Minority Report.
Yeah.
But if you're saying someone could plant a thought into you, I'm guessing it's going to... I have no qualification to speak on this. But the fact that you would, at least from the explanation, you would be able to differentiate between someone else's thoughts and yours.
No.
Like, surely you would know if so, like, if some, especially, in fact, you know what? In fact, I think it would be even more difficult to plant a thought into someone's head that way than it would be to just verbally say it.
Okay.
Because if you think about a thought is so unique to your own head, isn't it? Like,
yeah.
No one will ever have the thought that I'm having. So if a thought comes into my head that's not mine, I feel like it'd be so foreign in the way it's constructed that you'd be like,
do you feel that?
That's not mine.
Don't you think, like, I don't know, there's another train of thought thinking that we're all, like, all our thoughts are united somehow, right? And that,
yeah, and we just pluck them out.
Yeah, like, it's, yeah. So, I think like that too, but then I think, is that my ego talking, thinking that I have a really unique thought?
No, I think everyone could be trained. Because there's been people that have been intelligent, have joined cults.
Yeah, and got brainwashed.
Yeah. So if a smart person who was free thinking beforehand, be put in that situation, then putting something in there where they can actually directly put it into our head.
But okay, so this is kind of
when you're sleeping, just
taking both of those things that you're saying. If you think about, like, when people implant thoughts into the head, one of the biggest things is don't put too much detail into it.
Because
if you, the more detail you put into it, the harder it is for someone to buy into it. Like, you need to give them the general scope of something. Like, the whole idea of inception, you plant a seed and then it grows, right?
Yeah.
So if you're going to plant thoughts, it would have to be more like that. Like, I don't think you could cultify someone through a thought pattern. And like what you're saying about the ego side, I think, and this is why, because what you're saying about the ego side, my thoughts are unique and stuff. I think they genuinely are, just because your thoughts are a mixture of, or your thoughts are impacted by what you take in, the information you take in. But everyone takes in information completely differently because we have our own perception of stuff and we've all experienced things to different extents. That's why I think, like, a thought would be even more abstract, removed than language to the way that you think. Because, like, even if me and you have the same opinion, we're not going to express it the same way with the same words. No. So if a thought is even more far removed than the language itself, then, yeah, like, I don't know. Okay. I think the language is way far,
but I think people have the same thoughts. But the way that we explain it, it's going to be different. But people have the same thoughts. I think people have the same thoughts.
If you had the same thought, why would you explain it differently?
Because of the way that we grew up in the wherever, like our experiences and how we, the amount of language, you have a better grasp of language than I do. But we all have the same thought.
Interesting. Very interesting.
This is, by the way, that theory is a lot along the lines with different realms and dimensions and all that kind of stuff. I personally buy way more into the idea that we share like a census of thought, but even then I would think that your thoughts are still reactionary as well as they are proactive. So your thoughts, that's why, like, you take your perception of certain things come in and that impacts the thoughts you have in your head, which then impacts what comes out.
I'm just thinking someone could commit suicide through the chip. You make them stay awake.
I think there's a lot of benefits. There's a lot of benefits and a lot of downfalls. Because the chip could be Tesla, their cars get downloaded and upgrades, right? Mm. When you're sleeping, they could download upgrades in your brain so that you could be a better version of yourself, whatever, right? But at the same time, I hear what you're saying because I get it. There's something in your head that they can tap in. I get it. That's fucking scary. Don't touch my brain. There's not many things in this world that you have control of, right? And now when you're inserting something in your mindset, it's going to be one of the last things you have control in this life.
No, not just that. Your private thoughts as well, they could probably read.
But that's what I'm saying. You have control of your private thoughts. You have control of all that kind of stuff. And now you're letting someone enter that. It's sort of like...
So imagine the personal information that would get of people.
I get it, Sage. I'm with you. I'm saying 100%.
I think the majority of people would be the same. You might think something.
No, Sage, I get it.
You'll never say it.
Yes.
And now, because they're in your head, you just said it because you thought it.
Yeah, I get it.
Do you know what, as well, with that kind of thing? Like that, I have two thoughts on that. One, I think
they read it. They got the chip.
I think in the same way that you can think about like private thoughts, there's a lot of lonely thoughts. Like things that you think that you just cannot express to, no matter how hard you try, you cannot express what you're thinking to another person. And like being able to do that will be a sense, like will bring about a sense we've never experienced. Because you're sharing to a level you've never been able to share. But the other thing I was thinking, which is far more, I think, interesting, is do you think that if we do this, it's kind of going to be like a merging of consciousness and we're just taking a step closer and eventually we're going to merge all of ourselves into one being and we're going to be what is effectively God? Like, do you think...
Transformers.
Oh, wow, that's okay. Possible
today. Is that like Transformers? You go, Devin! And then you go, Alex! And then we all mash into one being.
That'd be crazy.
I go CJ.
It won't be CJ. He ain't got the chip.
When we're human beings, we had a gap. Now we're like one conscious. Can you give me some space, bro? Give me some space.
Give
me some space.
I'm not going to have the chip, so you'd be fine.
You would just be the guy out in the woods living off the grid.
I'm just thinking, like, imagine like two guys. One meets a girl. He just did to his mate or his brother. And his brother thinks, man, she's like, good looking.
Yeah.
And it's out there now.
Yeah. Yeah. I feel like you got a lot of secrets that you don't want anyone to know.
Yeah.
This is like the lock and key.
You've got like exact examples.
There's so much like...
I'm not saying there's examples here. I'm just thinking in sense where things you don't want to tell your mate or your family member.
Yeah.
Mate, you know, it's out
here. When it comes to things like that, like I remember... I think it was my dad was saying it to me before, like, because we're talking about like Alexas and Google Homes and all that kind of stuff. Like, are they listening to your conversations? It's that there's always that caveat of even if they recorded every conversation of everyone in Google Home and Alexa, there'd be no one to process it. Like, you couldn't. They don't have people sat there listening to them. Like, there isn't enough time in the day to do that. Mm-hmm. So even if they if everyone had a chip in their head, for example, like the more people that have it, the more secure you are from a privacy standpoint, because even if they could download your thoughts and your private, like, why is anyone going to be listening to CJ's private thoughts?
Yeah, so
bearing in mind the time that would take.
So, Alexander, me and CJ have watched a lot of crime movies and a lot of thrillers and that. It's when the government wants to attack you.
Yeah.
That's when you have to worry. Like, for the normal, when you're doing nothing and you're not outspoken and you're being beige, they're not going to come looking for you. It's when you've done something to upset them. It's sort of like, oh, now we've got this database. And it's all
categorized. But when have you upset them?
No, that's what I'm saying. I probably won't upset them for like 50 years. But the day that I do, they have a bank worth of information to just be like, now we're going to ruin this guy's life.
Yeah.
We're going to ruin
that's
his
what, again,
life.
Like, I feel like you would have to, first, again, like, let's put
so
these.
They might not categorize it, but they might store it.
Yeah.
Let's put these all into perspective.
Yeah.
There isn't enough storage space to store everyone's thoughts 24/7 forever.
No, 100%. 100%. Yeah,
so you couldn't, that would be one challenge. But then again, like, even like, what extent would you have to piss off the government for them to actually go to that resource?
Who knows?
For you. Like, you would have to go to some serious extent.
Well,
because
at the moment,
we're already at a point where, when you look from an investigative standpoint and everything, like, governments don't have the resource, one, to do it. And, like, how many criminals now, with more evidence than what you're trying to suggest, get away with stuff?
Yeah.
Because they're just like, look, we can't. We don't have time.
Yeah, but, you know,
but they won't be able to get away with it anymore because the chip are not a guilty.
Yeah, but you still have to put the resources in to find that information. Like,
it's
not like Dev commits a crime and then a computer goes, this is like Dev's worst moments. Like, instantly.
No, it's like he commits a crime and we're like, I think he did it. We'll download his thoughts and see if he did.
Oh, if he had.
But where are these thoughts?
But that was the same as Minority Report. That's what they were trying to.
Minority Report, we're trying to stop the crime before it happens.
Before it happens, but they had the thought.
Yeah, so what becomes a crime then? Having a thought?
Ooh.
Like, if I have a crime, like, F the government.
Yeah.
They should all die.
Yeah.
Is that going to be on a red flag watch list?
Oh.
And I'm saying that because that time of the day, I've just got my tax invoice. Yeah. And I'm like,
they got to put it in context, eh?
Yeah.
So that's been AI to put it in context.
So like, there's no context. They're just hearing
F
the government, they should all burn.
But then you can F with the AI because you can start saying, plotting a plan, but then you have your tax return in front of you. This is what I'm going to do. This is what I'm going to do. And this, and everyone, like your whole compadre has got their tax invoices in front of them. Just talking about how they're going to take the government down. And the AI is like, oh, I missed it because they had the texting voice in front of them, but they were thinking bad thoughts about the government. It's going to be like this level on level thing.
And then you just throw level. In.
It's really both levels.
No, and then you throw in, oh, I love the government. They're amazing.
Psych, psych.
I think they'll find out pretty quickly majority of people think a thought like that quite often. And then they'll be like, oh, shit. Right. I don't know, like that kind of AI like that, like we're far away from all this kind of technology. Like the stuff that Elon's talking about. Initially, and by the way, I didn't even talk about this because I just remembered, but this is probably more important. He said the initial instance of it would likely be around 2025. What it will be doing first is it will be fixing like brain injuries and physical injuries and stuff. So like if you're, for example, a paraplegic, it could re-stimulate the ability to be able, like, you'd be able to walk, you'd be able to walk the same as you used to, possibly better. I don't know how that makes sense, but, like, in terms of the ability to return function and stuff like that, so people have, like, Alzheimer's, anything like that, like, all these things would that's be able crazy. To...
Okay.
So that would be the initial, like, that's all they'd be working on initially. Yeah. It wouldn't be the ability to download data to you or anything like that.
Right.
Now, on another note, do you think we are causing the damage to the planet because we're all living much longer? Making something that's going to help us live even longer, is that going to be beneficial in the long run?
Yeah, but our mouths will be smaller and we won't have to eat.
Well, how are we going to digest food?
Like, we won't have to because we're
why?
Because we're going to be a massive conscious... Plan.
It could just be a tablet that we just take.
Am I just going to be like a bowl of goop?
We're going to lose our genitals, so use it while you can.
Could just be my breakfast vitamin, lunch vitamin, dinner vitamin.